welcome, welcome, welcome to Papa Stash Pop. This one's hot off the press, right? From someone that's been around forever, since I was a kid, which was a long time ago. If you're new to the channel or you're local but have never checked down in the description box, make sure you check down in the description box. There's always a video link, and that video is not on YouTube, but it's like, you know, usually a tutorial on, in this case, how to strum better. So check that out. It goes over upstrokes, downstrokes, exercises to help you get better at strumming, and then hopefully create your own strum patterns, you know, in your own songs, which would be awesome. So check that out. As for the song, it's only got a couple parts that, you know, reoccurring, and it's pretty easy. Most of the song is just one strum across one chord, and you're gold. So let's check it out. All right, so we got mostly open position chords. Now, you're going to see me throughout the video, sometimes I'll choose the bar chord form of the chord as well, but you can do, for the most part, again, almost all open position chords. Now, the really cool thing about the beginning, or the verse part, I should say, is all you really need to do to simulate the keyboard is just do one strum. So, for instance, okay, so if we're going to do that, it's going to be D minor, and you'd be kind of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So each chord gets two counts. It's going to go D minor to C to F. And then we're going to have to do a bar chord for this one. It's a G minor chord. So you just bar E to E on the third fret. And then the fifth fret, you have the A and the D. Then to round it out, you're going to go back to D minor, C, F, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So the verse, for the first part, before you get into the pre-chorus, again, goes like this. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? We'll do that three times the first time around. The next time around, in the second verse, it drops off one of those. Okay, so the second half of it is almost the same. It's got a lot of the same chords, but we're going to add an additional bar chord. Then it's going to go like this. So it starts out the same, D minor, C, F. So it's just like normal, but instead of the G minor, now we're going to do a B flat chord. Okay, so the B flat is A, first fret, and then the third fret of the D, G, and the B. Then you're going to go back to D minor, C, F, but instead of holding it for four counts, we're going to go to G minor. So that whole section there, the second half of the verse, so when you hit this G minor, it's going to hold that for a count of six. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Boom. Chorus. Okay. So let me play the verse all the way through. So I'm going to not count the first time when there's no vocals. Okay. So here we go. So let me play through the chorus really quickly, and then I'll break it down. It's very similar. We have a lot of the same chords. So check this out. Here we go. Okay, so if you notice, a lot of the chorus is B flat, F, C to D minor. That's gonna happen 4 times in the chorus, okay? So that happens the first time, and the strum pattern, we're gonna basically break it down. We're gonna try to simulate the drum. So we got, right? And then we basically come into the next chord. So it'd be. So the F. Okay, so the two together. So I do the same pattern for the first two chords that I do for the third and fourth chords, okay? So all together. Now this is the next time, which is the second time through, the only time the C chord repeats itself for two, you hold it for two counts, okay? So this one's gonna go. Keep the same strum pattern that we've been doing, but now instead of switching between two chords, the C has that whole strum pattern we've been doing, okay? Then we do the B flat, F, C, D minor 3 more times, but on the third time we actually hold the D a little bit longer, and that gets us into the tail end of the chorus. So we do the B flat, F, C, D minor 3 more times, okay? And then at the end of the third time, we hold the D for a little bit longer, and then we go C, F, G minor, okay? So with that in mind, let's break down the whole thing really slowly, okay? And I'll call out the chords. Here we go. B, F, C, D minor, B flat, F, C for 2, B flat, F, C, D minor, B flat, F, C, D minor, last time B flat, F, C, D minor, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so at the tail end, so we basically do the whole strum pattern on the D minor that we usually do, and then we count 2 more. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So after that D minor, we go C, F, G minor. Then you basically repeat the verse and the chorus, okay? So the only other different part of the song is the bridge, and we can do all downstrokes on this one. So check this out. The bridge is gonna be 8 counts on almost all the chords except for one section. So, the bridge, here we go. Okay, so that's the first part of the bridge, and that's gonna happen twice. So what I'm doing is I'm just doing downstrokes, and I played it loudly so you could hear what the chords sound like, but you can actually do more of a muted chorus, all right? So it's gonna start on D minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 to an A7 chord. So do an A chord, but keep the G string open. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do our B flat chord. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, the next one's gonna be 4 on F. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're gonna do a C chord, but with the E string. Okay, and just pick down to the B. Or actually, you don't even need to go down to there, but if you want to, at least hit E to G. But I'm going all the way down to the B. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So that repeats twice. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then what it's going to do is it's going to have a keyboard part that just basically is playing one note out of the chords, a little melody. But the chords themselves are going to be B-flat, F, C, D minor, just like the chorus. B-flat, F, C. And then it's going to break into the rest of the song. So if I played the whole bridge all together, here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, then you play one more chorus and you end it on the D minor chord. So in our first chorus, when we held that D minor and then we added the little extra time on it, all you do on this one is you get to that exact same part in the chorus, but instead of actually strumming the whole chord and doing that pattern, right, part of our rhythm strum pattern, we just downstroke and end on a D minor. So that chorus would sound like this. So we got...
to go. Again, don't forget the links in the description box below. This one is the strum link, so make sure you check that one out.
If it's your first time, again, welcome. Thank you for checking in. I'm glad that you're here. Out of the bazillions of channels you could have clicked on, you clicked here, and I'm just freaking stoked. So thank you. If you're local, again, you guys are amazing. I love each and every one of you. You're awesome. Thank you. Don't be afraid to check out Pop Stash 102 over there. There's a bunch of rock and electric guitar stuff and soloing. And then also, if you like what you see, by all means, share. I'm not going to care. That's going to be awesome. I would be stoked. So don't be afraid to share the videos. And then down below in the links, there's also papastash.com. And that is all about just me teaching you how to play guitar. So check that out as well. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your support. I'll catch you next time.